In this tutorial, we will look at Photoshop's Generative Fill AI tool. This tool allows you to easily remove, replace, and drastically change sections of a photograph. Let's get started. We are going to use AI to change some things about this photograph. So to use the AI tool in Photoshop, you do have to have the latest version of Photoshop, which is Photoshop 2024. So if you have an older version, make sure to update your software before doing this tutorial. So in this photograph, let's start by changing this man's outfit using AI. So to get started with Generative Fill, you have to select something in your photograph that you want to change. And then you're going to tell AI what you want to change about it. So I'm using the Polygon Lasso tool in my toolbar. I'm going to change his jacket to a different color shirt. So using this selection tool, I'm just going to loosely select around his jacket. And you have to close the selection. Just gonna go around his neck here. The selection is closed, and I can tell that by the marching ants that I see around the selection. And as soon as I select something, I got this Generative Fill AI pop-up box. If for some reason you don't see this, make sure you've selected something in the photograph and go to Edit and look for Generative Fill. We're going to our pop-up box. So now that I have a selection, I'm going to click Generative Fill. So I'm going to type my prompt here in this text box. I'm going to type red shirt, long sleeves. And you can get very detailed with this, or you can just put in a one-word prompt and see what happens. So now that I have my prompt, I'm going to click Generate. It's going to think for a minute. This is what the Photoshop Generative Fill came up with. And you can see on the right, it actually gives you three different options. I'm going to click through these. I said red shirt, long sleeve, and it only gave me one option that actually has a long sleeve red shirt. You can adjust this a little bit more. I'm gonna go back up here and maybe say something like red sweater, long sleeve, and I'm going to regenerate. So click generate again. You can move this box out of the way if it's covering up your subject. This is a little closer to what I was expecting. I now have three red sweaters, and let me click through the different options. There's a few strange things that I'm noticing. For instance, his body seems very narrow. It's also trying to recreate some of the plants, I think, that were in the foreground. I'm not sure what's going on here, so that one's a little weird. And then this last one, I do want to point out, anytime you're swapping anything in a photo and it involves hands, AI makes the strangest hands. There's some weird stuff going on here. That's kind of a fingernail, but not really. It's holding something. I don't think it does a very good job with hands. These are the variations that it's giving me, and these are all on a separate layer. You can very easily turn this on and off, this top layer, and see what your original was. As I mentioned, it narrowed this man a lot, and you can see it from the original. I'm going to stick with one of these. Okay, next thing we're going to change. Photoshop Generative Fill actually does an amazing job just removing things from photographs. In this photo, we are going to remove this plant that's kind of in the foreground here. It's a little distracting. Make sure we've got our background layer selected. I'm going to just select this plant, and I'm gonna start at the bottom. I'm gonna select the whole thing. Okay, so once I close the selection, I get my Generative Fill pop-up, going to click Generative Fill. And if you simply want to remove something from a photograph, you actually don't need to type anything here. Photoshop will blend your selection with the background and fill it in. So I'm just going to click Generate. And there we go. It removed that plant completely, and it's very seamless. I have three options here, and it's just giving me three different slight texture variations. But probably this first option is the best option. And let's go look at our layers. Again, it created another layer for this, and you can turn it on and off. We have one more little plant in the foreground that I will also select. Make sure I'm on my background layer. And let's do a Generative Fill just to remove this also. I think that looks pretty good. So if I wanted to use this photograph, I would simply save it as a Photoshop file or a JPEG. So let's move to a different photo, and I want to show you how drastically you can change a photo with the Generative Fill tool. So in this photo, I'm going to change this building to a completely different building. I'm going to remove this man, and I'm also going to replace the field that you see in the foreground. So let's start with this cool building in the background. I'm going to select the building. I'm going to actually replace it with a skyscraper. So I want to select a little bit more of the space above it so it swaps the image out and there's room for a taller building. With the selection created, I'm now going to type in my AI prompt. So I'm going to say skyscraper building structure and click generate. And let's see what it comes up with. So it's now giving me three different building options. I think I like this middle one the best. Next, let's go back to our background layer. We're going to remove this man completely. I'm just going to select him, click generative fill. And since I'm just removing him, I'm not going to put a prompt in. Photoshop will know to kind of fill in that space with the surroundings. So clicking generate only, let's see what happens. That did an excellent job removing him. I have a couple options here, but I think the first one works great. And then the last change I'm going to make, I'm going to swap out this foreground for a completely different field. Going back to my background layer, I'm going to just select the entire foreground and this field of grass. Click generative fill, and I want to fill this field with a field of flowers. I'm going to type that in, field of yellow flowers. Click generate. Okay, so here's what Photoshop came up with. I'm going to click through these, see what works best. Wow, this is interesting. This put city in the background too. I think this one looks pretty good. So going back to our layers panel, remember if I turn this off, look how different this photograph was when we started. So we removed the man, we changed the building, and we added a field of flowers. And it actually added a cityscape as well. So that is how you use the generative fill AI tool in Photoshop. Subscribe to Cry Studio for more Photoshop and graphic design tutorials. Thanks so much.